My name is Jim Grant. I'm a native of Peterborough, longest serving member on the Peterborough Fire Department. I'm now into my 50th year and have been very interested in the fire museum and the preservation of our historic equipment. What I really like to talk about today is that Timothy Driscoll was the longest serving fire chief, 27 years, and he was a transformational person. And in 1913, 14, 15, Peterborough upgraded their fire service thanks to him and his leadership and convincing the town that we needed to be upgraded and have new fire equipment. So during those 3 years, they built a stellar fire station. They put in a state-of-the-art fire whistle, and it's air-driven. It's still in operation today after 100 years. And when the fire whistle sounds, it can be heard for 8 miles, and it was the primary way of alerting people. And then the third thing, the fire station, the fire whistle, the third thing is they bought their first motorized fire truck, and they ordered it in 1914. It arrived on a flatbed railroad in spring of 1915. The truck was built in Elmira, New York, by the American LaFrance Fire Engine Company. The truck has 2,300 original miles on it, and it's 100 years old. And it starts with a crank. We were the only department in the whole rural area that had a motorized piece of equipment. It was a chemical wagon combination, and it was a hose wagon, so it carried 2,000 feet of hose, and it had two brass tanks with 35 gallons in each of the tanks. And the truck was in service from 1915 until 1938. In 1938, the select board had enough sense not to sell it. They knew at some point it would be an antique. And Major Erlen Guyette and Hazel Guyette were putting together a museum called the Guyette Museum of Early Americana. And on a handshake, they loaned the fire truck to the Guyettes for their museum, and along with all of the other artifacts that had been saved over the years. Back in those days, your word was your bond. And when she decided to close the museum, kept her word, called the fire chief, and said, "The equipment is yours." And at the same time, the beautiful brick building next to the firehouse was in tough shape. And the family, the Dyer Brown family, decided that what they would do is they would give the brick building next to the firehouse to the town, and then the fire department membership would remodel it and make it into a beautiful fire museum. And the person that spearheaded it was Fire Chief Merton Dyer, the local pharmacist. And we ended up, after his retirement, we named the museum the Merton S. Dyer Aquarius No. 1 Fire Museum to honor him and all of his work. And what's kind of interesting is the black and white pictures of the truck show a driver called Dyer Brown, and he was the person that maintained the truck. And Dyer Brown's son followed in his footsteps and became a firefighter, and he was the museum's curator. But what's fascinating is the man in the picture from the 1920s, late 1919, the truck is actually in his living room, because he gave us the building, his son did, his family did, and the fire truck is actually resting in his living room. So in 1919, he could never have dreamed that the truck he drove to fires would someday end up in his house. In 1995, we decided we were going to restore it. We tackled the restoration project. Now the next generation of firefighters have picked up, and they're restoring it.
When they asked me to take it over, so I said, well, I need somebody going to give me a hand, more experience. So I asked Dave to help me out, and he did a good job. You know, you do all the other stuff, and that's why we get stuck together since. So.
We work as a team. I mean, you know, he does some electrical stuff, I'll do some mechanical, and vice versa. I mean, we mesh in well together, troubleshooting. It takes a lot of mechanical agility. It takes a lot of MacGyvering, perhaps tinkering. We pull up a lot of resources from Jim Grant is a great one for contacts, and hey, where can we get a part from? You know, contact this person, and we have several people like that. So what we're trying to do is take over from Jim, and then we're hoping to pass it down to some gentleman below us, you know, to carry it on. Because when the thing is in parades, there is a lot of people clapping and very proud of seeing that truck
going.
Yeah.